Oh boy, this team is amazing. Hello everyone, Kedor here. So, yesterday I did a bit of testing with my own account, and it turns out that actually with Gear 13, you make this work pretty much every time. So, big shout out to my man Schmerz, a guildmate of mine, who has Gear 13 Rebels, and who sent me this footage, when it just shows that the team actually is absolutely awesome. So as you can see, every time, because Solo lands two crits, Kira gets two plays, call CLS, CLS gets some debuffs on Bastila, and that's how you start your little train thingy, and then you just blow them up. Because with Gear 13 you have way enough damage to do that. I couldn't get that to work yesterday because I don't have Gear 13 Han and Chewie, and they are the two ones making a huge difference there. Look at that. Chewie still has an extra thingy to do. You kill Bastila and Marauder, and you still have extra left. Yep! So then you go ahead and you fracture Malak, and you mop up. So this is great. This is just absolutely great. This team works beautifully. So, that's disgusting. So that allowed me to know some things that he told me. So first, this team wins every time against trooper teams. I only have Marauder footage, but against trooper that's just piece of cake. Then, well, the AI is definitely even more hard-coded than I thought, because HK is actually not a big problem, because he only uses his sniper move on CLS. So you kill Marauder, you leave HK alive at the start, and you're fine because he just does that. And then, as you can see, Malak is always a great sniper. So yeah! As long as you make sure that Thrawn is on the one that gets sniped by Malak, you're fine. See how he always goes for the lower health one? I really think that shouldn't even exist. That's hard coding just to make him better. Anyway. So, as you can see, this is pretty darn good. And that will give you, like, this is a lot of banners. This is actually a lot of banners when you think about it. That's killing a Darth Revan and Malak. I'm showing you the site right now, that the two teams that were used for this. This is the same team that I tested against yesterday. Schmerz is in my chart. That's the same guy, that's the same team. I couldn't make it work because of the gear. He has gear 13, it worked every time. That's as simple as this. I can't really tell you anything else. I mean, that's really good. That works all the time. So I'm going to go a bit step by step because I guess most of you haven't watched yesterday's video. But this team beats Darth Revan and Malak very reliably as long as you have the gear requirements. It is not an easy team to get. It needs really good speed and it needs some gear 13. So no, that's not an easy team to get and use, okay? So this is Schmerz's account. Let me show you his Rebels. He has a Gear 13 CLS that has good speed. That's nothing out of this world, but that's good speed, okay? So then you have Chewbacca. Chewbacca also has good speed. I mean, plus 100 is pretty good. And he hurts. Yeah, you need the Chewbacca to hurt. You need Chewbacca and Solo to hurt, like, a lot for this to work reliably. But as long as you have this, and as long as you have the required speed, see, Solo also has good speed. As long as you have the right speeds, and I'm going to tell you which one are the right speeds, you win every time. Well, not exactly every time, because they can get one dodge, and if they get that dodge, you're in trouble. But that's 2%. Other than that, as long as you have the right speed, you're fine. And I find this to be pretty amazing. I didn't, see his Kira, he had good speed on her too, and that's actually the most important part. The most important part of the team is getting the speed and the turn order right. There isn't really that much of a turn order, but that's getting Kira's speed right. So, CLS. So CLS give... I like my head where it is. Nah, this is better. Okay. So CLS, you need CLS at gear 13? Maybe not. It might, I'm saying might, it might work with a gear 12 CLS. I'm not 100% sure about it. But I do advise you to go gear 13, because he gets a lot of potency, gets some damage, and gets all that good stuff. Yeah, I won't tell you that's absolutely mandatory, but I really think you should have him gear 13 if you go for this team. You want to give him speed and you want to give him potency because you want him to land his debuffs. He actually gives more turn meter when he lands his debuff than when he doesn't. And he also gives more to Thrawn. Because Thrawn doesn't get turn meter from the resist, he only gets from CLS landing debuffs. So you want speed, potency. His speed, I'm not going to tell you everything that is behind it, but basically when he's called by Kira, he's landing some debuffs, they could get resisted. There also is some exposes, but you have only 50% chance for both exposes, so you have a 25% chance that you don't land any exposes. Anyway, if you want to be 100% sure that he gets to play at the right time, you want his speed to be 90% of the Sith Empire's best speed. So his speed divided by 0.9 must be higher than Sith Empire's speed. That's actually not that big of a deal. Most of the time, Sith Empire are around 330 something, so a 300 speed CLS can pull it out. You know, the more the better. But yeah, this needs to be true, okay? His speed divided by 0.9 must be higher than Sith Empire T. Once you have that, you're golden, okay? Okay. And give him God. Giving God, Peles. So, HK is hard-coded to shoot at CLS every time in this specific situation. If you don't have God, he might die. Giving God. And he just eats up HK's damage just fine. That's basically all you need. But yeah, that's not that hard to get, honestly, on CLS. So after that... Nice. So, solo. For solo, you do need gear 13. If he's not gear 13, he doesn't do enough damage. That's basically all there is. Yesterday when I did my testing with my own account, my solo is gear 12.4 and that wasn't enough. And by quite a bit. But yeah, gear 13 solo, just fine. Give him a crit damage set, a crit chance set, crit damage triangle and an offense cross. While you have it, you're golden. Then for speed, you have to aim for the 270 something speed. That's not like 100% required, but if worst case scenario, every debuff is resisted and you don't get the exposes and such, you will need 270 to be sure that he gets to play before Sith Empire. Okay? That's why I say aim for. It's really good if you have it. It's not absolutely required, but it does give you the turn even in the worst case scenario. Okay? And he needs to hurt. You want offense secondaries. You want damage. You want him to blow some holes in that Bastila. That doesn't sound really good. Yeah. So after solo, Chewbacca. No, I don't like this one. No, Chewie deserves to have his face shown. So, gear 13. Yeah. I'm putting that here too, but, you know, I'm pretty sure that you do need him to be gear 13 for the damage alone. This might not be true, you might make it work with a good gear 12 Chewbacca, but you should have him gear 13 for survivability alone and for the raw damage that it adds up, and for the speed and all of that good stuff. So yeah, probably have him gear 13. Crit damage set, crit chat set, crit damage triangle offense cross, aim in the 270. Same as solo, basically they do the same job. He needs to hurt. Again, you need your Chewbacca to hurt. And, well, since he's not really in the same realm as solo, I'm probably expecting an offense set to be good enough, HP secondary set to be enough too. You know, might just work. Thrawn, my boy, Papa Smurf. So, Thrawn right there, he's helping the rebels. Yeah, I know, that's weird. But you need him. You can't not have him in the team. If you don't have him in the team, that means you can fracture Malak. That means your rebels are stuck behind a taunting Malak. That means you're dead. You want reliability? Bring Thrawn with you. Okay. The good thing is, you only need him gear 12. He is pretty tanky in himself, so he won't take guard. CLS needs guard, again. Give him speed, give him HP, give him protection primaries. And just make him pass. So he only gains turn meter from CLS landing his debuffs. When I played the team, I had my own Thrawn at 290 speed. I think that's a bare minimum. I really think that's like... Don't go under that threshold. 290 is like the minimum for him. If you have him close to gear 13, slap that gear 13 on Thrawn because he deserves it. It's an amazing tune. He's still, in my mind, the best tune in the game because he does everything. So yeah, basically that's all you need for him. And then, the real star of the show, you know, that good old 3PO replacement, Kira. So, yeah, not me. So Kira is there to replace 3PO. 3PO can go with Padme. That's amazing. And she actually is more reliable than 3PO. She's straight better than 3PO. Because her passive always gives her 15% turn meter because Han always gets 2 crits, so she always plays before Sith Empire as long as you get the speed right. Then she calls CLS, you put your debuffs, and your little train gets rolling. And that's better than waiting for 3PO to get resisted and give exposes to the other one to get resisted. Especially if you have gear 13 Han. You won't make the team with 3PO work with gear 13 Han. So, yeah, Kira is just straight better. And the only thing you need is a gear 12 one, some speed and HP, because you want that's all she's good for, just be there to be tanky. She's quite tanky, so you will be fine. Protect primaries. Speed must... Okay, I'm going to show my face again, because when I emphasize something, I think it's better if you see my face. Use the speed must be 85% of Sith Empire team. Her speed divided by 0.85 must be higher than the opposing team's speed. If you don't have that, you can't make the team work. In the example, the best speed in the team is Revan at 329, the Kira is at 291 or 2, that's just good enough. Just good enough. So you need her fast. That's not an easy team to get. You need good speed. Okay? Okay. So once this is said and done, last quick look maybe at the Zetas. So I don't think that you need my advice on this. I mean, if your Rebels are gear 13, you have them anyway. So CLS lead and it binds all things. Solo, of course, you need the Zeta on Solo. Duh. Chewies are not mandatory, but the one that gives protection back is really good if you want better banners. So I do recommend this a lot. Thrawn, of course, you don't need the Zeta on the lead. The second one does help. He gets more counterattacks, so you know. And Kira's Zeta is awesome. You should use it. It's probably not mandatory, but it gives damage and potency. That's two things you need. So yeah, I don't see any reason not to slap that Zeta on Kira. Anyway, some more footage. So Schmertz was good enough of a man to send me multiple examples of him taking down that Darth Malak team with that one. And it just works beautifully. Get 2 crits, call on Bastila. Okay, I wouldn't advise to use that special, because you might need the heal later on, and you don't really need that right now. But here you go. She's just blasting through that team, you know. Kill Bastila. Please. Kill Bastila. Thank you. Then kill Marauder. Kill Marauder, always. Don't go for HK. Kill Marauder, because HK is hard-coded to go after CLS. Marauder isn't. Marauder will fuck your day up. Marauder doesn't care. Marauder will throw at Thrawn or Chewie. But see, every time, you will get 2 dead before they even get to play. They have 2 guys dead. Malak is under fracture. And then they get like a turn. Oof, that hurts. And then you just finish these 2 guys off. And then you just flick Malak off. Malakhov. Malakhov. Which is a city, by the way, in France. But anyway, here you go. That's actually, that looks like really easy, you know. Snipe. So again, still hard-coded. Malak, still hard-coded. Still will go for the lower one every time. Again, lower one. Hard-coded. I told you that that was the case, and that just checks out every time. Call Thrawn. Call Thrawn, mate. Call Thrawn with that. Yeah, nice. So Thrawn also in his basic has an unresistible stun. So that's really good against Malak, actually. Yeah, you can get that rolling every time. So when you get to this point, CLS might be alive, but you have so many stuns, and you have Fracture. So, okay, it's taking a bit long, because it's Malak. But, yeah, I mean, that fight is won, and you have good banners. Looks pretty good, doesn't it? I like it. 4 alive, good protection. Eh. Okay, so he goes to HK first this time. Hey, maybe that was a test, you know? But, yeah, go for Marauder. That's a lot better. Go for Marauder. Again, don't use that special, keep it. Keep that special for later, when CLS has shock and you want him to be healed. That's a bit better, I think. So that's okay. He's trying to go for HK this time. That's interesting. I think that's a lot. No, but I think that's a bit worse, because yeah, he told me himself that actually you should go for Marauder every time, because HK just goes for CLS and that does nothing. You know, like, so this fight is actually interesting because he killed only one before getting to the rest. You know. So yeah, that might actually, see, HK always goes there. Okay, Marauder went for someone with guard, so that's fine. But it could have been bad, you know. Look at Thrawn, he's pretty low, so that could be a bit dicey. Okay, Marauder could have killed Thrawn right there, for example. But he didn't, so you know, that's fine. But yeah, good example. I still think he's going to win this, because I mean, just look at that, you have 5 guys and Malak is alone. But they're a bit lower, you know, so yeah, good example. Thanks for this one. Snipe, again, see, always checking out, always that drain going for the lower one. That's, I actually don't like it, because that's like, you know, that's making difficulty up. That's just making difficulty up. Oh, let's give that guy a better AI than the other guy. Oh, call Thrawn, no, oh, too bad. If he called Thrawn there, that was an automatic stun, because he had the ability block. So if you have ability block and Thrawn basics you, you are stunned 100%. That's non-resistable. So yeah, Thrawn could have been alive there. I hope that doesn't come back to bite him in the ass. Doesn't look like it. Oh fuck. I mean, yeah, the fact that Kira is there is pretty great, because you get to call Thrawn, and Thrawn can stun. Yeah, be aware of what the basics does. So of course CLS basic is really good in can stun, but it's not 100%. Thrawn is 100%. So yeah, go for Thrawn if you can. Don't tell me he's going to lose this. That was so good. I mean, that's the little things, you know. He didn't went for Marauder first, and then he didn't use that basic of Thrawn. Yeah, that's a good point to make. Don't forget Thrawn basic is actually absolutely amazing. Front basic is amazing. Use basic. Don't use that. Shit. Basic was better. Yeah, okay, you get this. Okay, that's fine. You got it. So, here, if that wasn't a Gilfert in Chewbacca, that wasn't happening. Okay, so, again. Go for Marauder. Yeah, nice. Go for Marauder. Then, Kira goes for Bastila. She's gonna clear that whole side. And that basic of CLS is starting the little train. Okay, only one debuff. That's enough. Use... Now don't use that. Okay, no biggie. No big difference. Then use that. That's fine. Then shoot... I mean... Yeah, I mean, why not? You still have... Oh, that's disgusting. Okay. So yeah, Rebels are just nasty. They do so much damage. Compare this to what I did yesterday with my gear 12. And there is like a huge difference. I couldn't kill both of these guys. I couldn't kill two before they play. And he does that and he still has some extra because Chewie has a move left. You know, that's actually kind of disgusting. See, again, just sniper shot on the lead. He will always do that. So you don't really care about HK anyway. That's just at this point. That's just mopping up. You know that's really easy. Malak is not a concern because he's under fracture, and you finish the game. And there. That's really easy to do. That's actually really easy to do. Yeah, I mean, why not? That's only on Chewie, but hey. I guess, yeah, you can try little stuff because, yeah, he's going to fear you and stuff. No point trying to give him, I see him using the grenade. There isn't really a point because the thing when their turn meter gets away doesn't work on them because of the lead. Anyway, yeah. Use basic! Okay, yeah, I mean save her because you don't want her to get drained. Okay, 4 turn meter maybe? Yeah, sure, why not. Basic was a stun. Yeah, nice. That's a dead Malak again. That's taking way too long because, you know, that finishing of Malak part is painful. That hurts, I don't like it. But here it is. So, little reminder, as always. Let me hide my face a second. So, Blast Marauder. Kira calls CLS on Bastilash and Fallen. You kill Bastilash and Fallen and Marauder with CLS, Lu and Chewie. You have enough damage for that. That's really easy to get. You have enough damage for that. I mean, just watch the video again if you don't believe me. He still had some extra. Chewie still had a hit. Then Thrawn fractures Malak. So at this point, there is only 3 of them. One is under fracture. I mean, that sounds pretty darn good. I do advise you to keep CLS second special for the heal and take shock off. And Schmert himself told me that that it was actually better for banners, you know, against for banners, than finish them off. Versus Trooper, I know there is no footage of this versus Trooper, but believe me, that's like extra easy. You just get CLS special on Trooper, he has buff immunity. Enough. You kill Bastila, then you kill HK, and they don't have any damage that you could be afraid of. That's it. That's just it. That's really easy. So yeah, that's a really good team. That works. Again, needs some gear 30. Needs some really good speed. I can't emphasize that enough. That does need some really good speed. So that's not an easy team to get. Okay. That's going to need a 300-ish and something CLS. That's going to need 290 Thrawn, 270 Chewbacca and Han, and Kira needs to be at 85% of Sith Empire's speed. Once you have that, and once you have gear 13 on Solo and probably Chewie, so that's enough damage, you're good. Team works every time. I thank you a lot for watching this one again. I hope this was helpful. I think it is. Be sure that I myself will gear 13 my rebels for the next Grand Arena if I can. In the meantime, see you guys. Thanks a lot for watching.